my friend. We are all interested in the future, for that is where you and I are going to spend the rest of our lives. And remember, my friend, future events such as these will affect you in the future. You are interested in the unknown, the mysterious, the unexplainable. That is why you are here. And now, for the first time, we are bringing to you the full story of what happened on that fateful day. We are giving you all the evidence based only on the secret testimony of the miserable souls who survived this terrifying ordeal. The incidents, the places. My friend, we cannot keep this a secret any longer. Let us punish the guilty. Let us reward the innocent. My friend, can your heart stand the shocking facts about grave robbers from outer space?
Hello, I'm Alex Jones, and I'm a radio and television host based in Austin, Texas. And for many years, I've been exposing the criminal activities of the global elite, also known as the New World Order. In past films, we've documented the centralization of power, the move toward world government, the attack on the nation state, self-defense, the Second Amendment, family values, that is, the family itself, as well as private property rights. But time and time again in my research, I come, well, eye to eye with something that's even hard for me to believe. And that's that the elite, again, the so-called establishment teams, those that know best, the visions of the anointed ones, are obsessed with the occult. From presidents to governors to the heads of industry. We've all seen the stories of presidents and first ladies obsessed with their astrologers making national policy decisions upon their recommendations. Spiritual guides, shamans in the White House. My friends, it gets far worse than that. Now, I personally am a Christian, but even an atheist should be concerned about the information we're about to bring forward in this new documentary film, The Dark Secret, Inside Bohemian Grove. You see, for over 120-plus years in Northern California, in Sonoma County, on a 2,700-acre secluded redwood grove, leaders from around the world, prime ministers, chancellors, presidents, governors, again, the heads of industry, banking, academia, the media, Hollywood, only a select few, a little over 2,000 people, traveled there to engage in bizarre, ancient Canaanite, Luciferian, Babylon mystery religion ceremonies. At least that was the rumors. And so I went to the library and got on the internet and saw many of the mainstream news articles admitting that world leaders do indeed go there, and they fly into San Francisco and other surrounding cities and drive out into the rural hills and mountains of Northern California, and that these stories have been coming out that they worship some 45-foot stone owl god. And then I began to read some of the documentation on this Moloch character of the Old Testament, mentioned many times in Leviticus. That's in the Bible. Why are world leaders traveling to the middle of nowhere to worship this thing? Well, I have to check it out for myself. And I'm proud of my team. I can't see Violet Nichols. They traveled with me there. We talked to some of the locals discreetly. We successfully infiltrated with the help of some of the locals and Channel 4, World of Wonder, British Television that teamed up with us. And I successfully infiltrated through the Secret Service, through the guards, through the Sonoma County Sheriff's Department. We were inside 4 hours. That's only one day out of the 2 weeks that they meet there for the admitted summer fire festival of the Bohemian Club. Well, basically that's enough for me. It's hard to even describe it with words. And I hope that our hidden cameras can give you at least a small peek of what I witnessed. To have world leaders engaging in this type of sickening behavior. Oh yes, there's much more to come. Mock human sacrifices, they claim, just shocks the very foundation of what Americans believe their leaders to be. And then to have it intimately connected with world government. It doesn't make a lot of sense until you research history. All throughout history, spanning back into the midst of the beginnings of civilization, we see world leaders from the empires of old, from the Aztec kings and priests, to Babylonian leaders, to ancient Rome, engaging in twisted behavior. Could it be that when you have all the power, all the women, all the money, and all the land, and all the art, you have to do something new? You have to go against the basic grain of humanity. You have to get off in a sick way. That's what we witnessed in Northern California, July 15th, 2000. Get ready to go inside the Bohemian Grove. It was the night of July 15th, 2000. Mike Hansen and I were about to attempt the first ever successful infiltration of the Bohemian Grove. Others have tried to fail. No one has ever actually made it in and out with video evidence. After careful planning, we decided the best tactic would be to insert ourselves about a half mile from the main entrance into the heavily wooded area, entering the gorge by stealth and getting into the main parking area. From there, we posed as Bohemian Club members, thus entering the inner sanctums of the New World Order. We don't have time in the documentary to show you an entire tour of the 2,700-acre compound in the middle of the gorge. Besides the fact we didn't even have time to see but about 20% of it in between dodging security personnel. Unfortunately, we were using digital tapes that were 1 hour. Several of the confrontations were not caught on tape. We had sheriffs, deputies, Secret Service, you name it, question us on who we were. We just told them we were with the hillbillies. That's where the bushes stay. You know, because we've got Texas accents.
Like a boys' camp, the Grove has a symbol, in this case, a somewhat fierce-looking owl. It also has a patron saint, St. John of Nepomuk, a legitimate 13th-century Bohemian canonized for his sense of honor.
Bring it back.
It also has a patron saint, St. John of Nepomuk, a legitimate 13th-century Bohemian canonized for his sense of honor.
Now, I personally am a Christian.
My brother in arms.
My friends, it gets far worse than that.
We are here today to unleash a juggernaut of truth.
I mean, it isn't question whether our movement is infiltrated. Oh. Absolutely is.
Who do you think's an infiltrator? I'm wondering.
Well, is the camera running?
Those who would not want to hear this are in denial. But as a teacher, I'm asking only to hear what I have to say.
And that's the Bohemian Grove.
It is with great honor that I introduce our next speaker. Please join me in welcoming my friend, my comrade, my brother in arms, ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only, Alex Jones.
We are all interested in the future, for that is where you and I are going to spend the rest of our lives, whether we want to or not.